Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my 7th lesson of D2, chapter number 5, exercise 5A. That is about solving quadratic equation by factorization. In this lesson, I will solve intermediate level question number 7. Question says solve each of the following equations. Let's move to A part of the question. A part of the question is 121 minus A square equals to 0. If you look at the question, question is the application of difference between two squares, and according to that we know that if we have a square minus b square, this is equal to a plus b multiplied by a minus b. So what we have to do is we have to think about the number whose square is 121. 11 is the number whose square is 121. So I will write it in the form 11 square minus a square equals to 0. Now this side, left hand side of the equation is expressed in the form of a whole square minus b whole square, and now I have to write it in the form a plus b multiplied by a minus b. So according to that it will become 11 plus a multiplied by 11 minus a equals to 0. In order to solve the equation, I have to apply either our condition, either 11 plus a will be equal to 0 or 11 minus a will be equal to 0. To find the value of the variable, I have to shift this constant to other side by changing the sign. When I will be shifting 11 to other side, it will become a equals to minus 11 or minus a equals to minus 11. If we look at minus a equals to minus 11, we can see that both sides of the equation are having minus sign, so we can cancel the minus sign and my answer will be a equals to 11. A equals to 11. If we look at the roots or the solution of equation, we can see that both the answers are 11 but with opposite sign, so it's better to write the combined answer that a equals to plus minus 11. Very easy question. Let's move to the second part of the question. It says 128 minus 2b square equals to 0. If we look at 128 and 2, they are not perfect squares. In order to apply the difference between two squares, the numbers before minus sign and after minus sign must be the perfect squares. So we have to try to make these two numbers the perfect squares. So what we can do is, if we look at 2 and 128, table of 2 is suitable for 128. I can extract 2 as a common factor. So when I'm extracting 2 out from 128, 2 6 and 2 4 I will left with 64, and from minus 2b square this 2 is out and I will left with b square equals to 0. Then I have to shift this 2 to other side and my equation will take the form 64 minus b square equals to 0. Now at this stage you have to express left hand side of equation in form of the identity a whole square minus b square. So think about the number whose square is 64. So 8 whole square minus b square equals to 0. Now write it in the form of a plus b multiplied by a minus b. 8 plus b into 8 minus b equals to 0. In order to get the value of the variable, apply either our condition, either 8 plus b equals to 0 or 8 minus b equals to 0. To solve this linear equation, shift the constant to other side by changing the sign. Shift constant to other side by changing the sign. When I will be shifting 8 to other side, b will be equal to minus 8, and from the second part minus b equals to minus 8. Both sides of the equation are having minus sign, so we can cancel them, so the value of b will be 8. Again look at the roots that we are getting, that the answer is coming same with opposite signs, so it's better to write the combined answer that b equals to plus minus 8. Very easy questions. If you have the command on the identities, then this question will not be difficult for you at all. Moving to C part of the question, that says C square minus 1 by 4 equals to 0. Express it in form of the identity c whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square equals to 0. Now write them in the form a plus b multiplied by a minus b, c plus 1 by 2 into c minus 1 by 2 equals to 0. Now apply either our condition, either c plus 1 by 2 equals to 0 or c minus 1 by 2 equals to 0. In order to get the value of the variable, shift constant to other side by changing the sign, and it will become c equals to minus 1 by 2, c equals to minus 1 by 2 or c equals to positive 1 by 2. And at this stage, again observe carefully that both the roots are same with opposite signs. So write the answer, combined answer, c equals to plus minus 1 by 2. Very easy and very interesting questions. Let's quickly move to the next part of the question. That is 4 over 9 minus d square by 25 equals to 0. For these questions, you should have the command on the squares and square roots and mental maths calculations. Think about the numbers whose squares are 4 and 9 and 25 and express them in form of the identity. For 4 by 9, I have to write 2 by 3 whole square minus d by 5 whole square equals to 0. Then write in form of a plus b, 2 by 3 plus d by 5 into 2 by 3 minus d by 5 equals to 0. Now apply either our condition, either 2 by 3 plus d by 5 equals to 0 or 2 by 3 minus d by 5 equals to 0. In order to get value of the variable, shift constant to other side, shift constant to other side by changing the sign, and I'll be shifting this whole fraction to other side. D by 5 equals to minus 2 by 3. This 5 is in the denominator. When I'll be shifting it, it will be multiplied with 2, and we will have d equals to minus 10 by 3 or d equals to minus 3 whole 1 by 3. Coming to the second part, minus d by 5 equals to minus 2 by 3. Both sides of the equation are having minus sign, so cancel them and make it positive. And then after that, shift this 5 to other side, it will become d equals to 5 multiplied by 2, 10 by 3, or d equals to 3 whole 1 by 3. Write down the combined answer, that d equals to plus minus 3 whole 1 by 3. 3 whole 1 by 3. I hope you are clear about this question. For better understanding of this question, please have the command on the tables. Let's move to question number 8. Question 8 says, solve the following equations. The question is 7f plus f square equals to 60. The question is the quadratic equation, but it's important to observe that this quadratic equation is not in standard form because the square term is at the second place and constant is towards the right hand side. So rearrange this equation and make it in the standard form. So what I will be doing, I will write f square plus 7f and shift this 60 to other side, minus 60 equals to 0. Now this equation is the standard quadratic equation. Now what I have to do, I have to apply Heaton trial method here. I have to multiply this 60 with the coefficient of the term having part 2, and product will become 60 with minus sign. Make the prime factors of 60, 2 30s are, 2 15s are, and 3 5s are, and 5 1s are. Set the factors 2, 2, 3, 5, and 1 in such a way that when we add or subtract, we get the middle term, which is 7, and when we multiply, we get minus 60. if I'm taking 12 and 5, 12 and 5, 12 minus 5 can give me 7, and 12 multiplied by 5 can give me 60. So this is the suitable choice. Let's move to the question, and I have to write f square plus 12f minus 5f minus 60 equals to 0. Now my middle term has been divided in two parts. Now make the groups of like terms, taking some number or letter as a common factor. If we look at f square plus 12f, we can pull out f. When I'm writing f outside, inside the bracket, I will write f plus 12. Coming to the second part, minus 5f and minus 60, both the terms are having minus sign, so I can extract minus sign out. And for 60, table of 5 is suitable. How many times? 5 12s are 60. Here you should have the command on the tables as well. 5 into f plus 12 equals to 0. Very easy questions. Now see that this f plus 12 is the common group. Extract it out. Pull it out. F plus 12 into f minus 5 equals to 0. In order to solve the equation or to get the roots, apply either our condition. Either f plus 12 equals to 0 or f minus 5 equals to 0. To find the value of variable, quickly shift this constant to other side by changing the sign, and it will become f equals to minus 12 or f equals to 5. So the two roots of this equation are f equals to minus 12 or 5. I hope you are clear about this question. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Watch my lessons, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.